as the class is about to go out for their pictures, we're going to talk to them, chat with them, and see how they're feeling today. It's a really exciting moment. We're really thankful all of you could join us today. Hello, hello, how are you? What's your name?
Good, thank you. My name is Aria Minisale.
Nice, Aria. How are you feeling today? How's everything going?
Feeling amazing. It's graduation day.
Lovely, lovely. Do you have a message for your parents? I know it's a special day for
yes.
you, your family
thank
as well.
Thank you so much for supporting me. Love you all and see you in a few hours.
Thank you. Have a nice picture. Take care. Bye-bye. Hello, how are you? Gala, we need to have a chat with Gala.
Hello.
Gala, how are you today?
I'm good, thank you.
How are you feeling? You're finally graduating. It must be really exciting.
Yeah, it's super, super exciting. Finally, after a long time.
It's been a while.
But I'm very, very happy and very excited to be here with everyone.
That's lovely.
In COVID.
In COVID
still,
times as well.
Yeah.
Do you have plans for after the graduation? Something's going on?
Yes. So basically, I'm just having dinner with my family every time.
Lovely.
The family is always.
Absolutely. That's lovely. Thanks. I won't keep you long. Have a nice picture. Take care. Thanks. And with that, we'll catch everyone in a bit. We'll be tuning in again around 4 o'clock or 5 p.m. for further updates with the graduation. Thank you. Welcome again. We are currently at President Wilson, which is one of the most luxurious hotels here in Geneva, and we're absolutely honored and glad to be here. It's a really special moment. It's a special moment for the people that are graduating. It's a special moment for the parents as well. Of course, the children are graduating, but the parents don't have to pay the credit card bills anymore. So equally happy moment, and we hope that you're able to enjoy this as much as we are. Thank you. We will be interviewing a few people shortly.
How is everyone today? How are you guys feeling?
Yeah, all good.
Great.
Amazing.
Yeah. Happy to be graduating.
Super happy, ecstatic even.
Oh yes, we are.
Well, that's lovely. That's lovely.
And what about your plans? Any plans for after graduation?
Well, after graduation, we're going with Ralph somewhere to drink, to celebrate, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Best way to go.
Yeah.
Best way to go about it.
Of course.
Lovely. Won't take much of your time. Have a nice one, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye bye. And we have with us Kusha. Hi Kusha, how are you today?
Good. It's good to see you.
Very good as well. So Kusha, maybe can you tell us about your uni experience, best things you liked so far in this?
To be honest, I've been to the three campuses. Geneva campus is one of the best to educate yourself because it's more practical than theory. And to be honest, you get to know a lot of people around here from different nations, different countries, and it helps you to widen your network, which is business all about. So
definitely.
I had a phenomenal time, and I would definitely do it again if you go back.
Lovely, wise words. Thank you. Have a nice one, Kusha. Bye-bye. And we're going to have a quick chat with Thomas. Thomas, Eva, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
How are you feeling?
I'm excited to be graduating.
Finally,
even with COVID around, we managed to do something. So
that's true. Special moment. Maybe if you could tell us some of the best moments of yours in uni. I know you're really keen on football, played for the football team as well.
Yeah, I played for football. It was always fun playing against different universities. Always a lot of activities, always fun. It was a good experience. Before COVID came around, but it's always been fun all year round.
It is what it is. Thank you for the chat. I'm sure the football team will miss you. Have a nice one, Thomas. Thank you. We have another really interesting guest today. Hello, how are you today?
Good. How are you, Mazen?
What's your name?
It's Jeremy Nette.
Nice to meet you, Jeremy. What major did you do?
I did a communications and public relations major.
Fantastic. That's interesting. And how are you feeling today, finally graduating?
Really happy. It's been a long time coming. 3 years, lots of hard work. So it's nice to celebrate the good degree.
That's good. So is it fair to assume the tassel was worth the hassle?
I would say so, yes. I would agree with you on that. Yeah, it's a good play on words, yep.
Lovely. Cheers. Thank you, Jeremy. Have a nice one. Bye-bye. And we're going to have a quick chat with the graduates, Titiksha and Olivia.
How are you?
We're good.
Really like you guys' outfits, twinning today
almost. That's lovely. How are you guys feeling today?
Good. Very, very excited about it.
That's
it's crazy that it's over the 3 years. It's crazy to be here all of a sudden.
I'm going to put you guys on the spot. What was your favorite class so far from all of the ones that you've taken?
Mine would be Business, Finance and Accounting with Professor Strom.
Of course.
course.
For me, any of my major classes, especially political science, diplomacy, those classes, I love them. Yeah.
Lovely, that's fantastic. And what do you girls have planned for later on? Some things in the works?
Yeah, currently I'm interning at an NGO, so.
That's lovely. And yourself, Olivia?
I am going to do my master's in the Netherlands starting September, so very excited.
That's lovely. I wish both of you all success and thanks for the chat. Thank you. Have a nice one. As you can see, the graduates super pumped up, super keen. Everyone's wanting to take a few pictures. It's a really special moment for all of them. And once again, I'd like to say thank you so much for joining in to make this day even more special. It's a really special moment. Could we maybe get that? Fantastic. It's time for the pictures. Good times for sure, definitely moments to cherish for the graduates. As you can see, the graduates are having a really good time. We'll take a bit of a breather and we'll be back at 5 p.m. with the graduation ceremony live for all of you. Thank you so much.
Before we begin, switch off your telephone so that nobody calls you in the middle. Switch off Siri. This is live streamed. So there's the word live in there. We are alive. This is not virtual. And whatever was virtual was also real. So let's be alive. Let's be streaming and screaming. So please unmute your face during this, and you can shout and you can applaud. You should applaud at least as many times as we have successes, minus one, because out of modesty you should not applaud for yourself. My name is De Jong, Stef De Jong, for those who didn't know. I would normally announce that I can write upside down, but that's totally useless this year. But I still know how to do that. I am the Dean and Professor of EU Business School for the Swiss campuses. And welcome to all of you. Welcome to the Board of Trustees. Welcome to distinguished guests, academic partners, President Crane, faculty, the staff, parents who follow us, who witnessed this happening, families, friends, and the class of 2020 and the class of 2021. So, welcome to the EU Business School commencement ceremony. Today is dedicated to you, the men and women who have arrived at one of the most important events of your lives. Your success in getting here is a significant achievement. Many of you have distinguished records in academia and in the service to the institution, which you carried out during your time at EU Business School. All of you are to be congratulated. I hear nothing. No? Oh, thank you. Thank you. This was just a test, so I wanted to see whether you're still alive, because in the end, if I get all mute and no camera, then we don't want that. We also congratulate the parents, the husbands, the wives, the partners, the families, the friends, and the fools of our graduating students who are following us on the live stream for assisting them in meeting their goals. Today, we have 21 nationalities among our graduating students. This multicultural environment, that is our strength. In addition to what you've learned, you may have learned a few things through your friends and to the classmates and to this whole experience that we went through in these last periods. At EU, our common language is English. And even though there's a very few mother tongue English, we all speak that international language together. But we would like you to offer a warm welcome. And we'll do that in several languages, and we'll start with Ozzy Plummer, because he can speak real English.
Dear distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure and an honor to welcome you today to the 2021 commencement ceremony. All our congratulations go to the graduates, their relatives, and friends of the 2021 class. Dear graduates, we wish you a great start in your future endeavors.
Très chers invités, mesdames et messieurs, c'est avec beaucoup de plaisir et d'honneur que nous vous recevons aujourd'hui pour notre remise de diplôme 2021. Toutes nos félicitations aux familles et amis de la classe 2021. Chers diplômés, nous vous souhaitons le meilleur pour le début de votre carrière.
That was in French, and now I have a German text in front of me, but I was asked maybe I should do this in Dutch. So, zeer geëerde gasten en alle dames en heren die hierbij aanwezig zijn, het is voor mij een groot plezier en eer u alle hier welkom te heten op dit commencementfeest. En mijn bijzondere groet gaat uit naar de ouders, want dit is de grootste bijdrage aan deze levensfase. En ze zijn misschien hier niet fysiek aanwezig, maar ze zien ons livestream. Daarmee wens ik dan iedereen veel geluk in deze volgende levensfase, want nu begint het pas echt. The following is Anastasia, and she'll speak in Russian.
Дорогие гости, мы рады приветствовать вас на церемонии вручения дипломов 2021 года. Поздравляем выпускников, а также их родителей и друзей с этим знаменательным событием. Дорогие выпускники, желаем вам успехов во всех будущих начинаниях. Спасибо.
And our next welcome is by José Lamas, who wrote yesterday, Hasta Mañana, which is what I understand in Spanish, but he can do much more now.
Distinguidos invitados, es un gran honor recibirles hoy aquí en la ceremonia de graduación de la promoción del año 2021. Nuestra más sincera enhorabuena a todos los graduados, familiares y amigos. Estimados graduados, damas y caballeros, os deseamos lo mejor en vuestros futuros proyectos. Con mucho amor.
As you may have noticed, they all say about the same thing. Suda is now going to do this in Hindi, which is more difficult to check.
Priya Devi aur Sajano, aap sabko EU Business School ki taraf se ye 2021 saal ki graduation day pe swagat hai. Ye hamare liye badi samman ki baat hai ki aap yahan hamare saath aa sakte aur ho sakte hain. Priya graduates, EU Business School ki taraf se hum sab hum aap aur aapke parivar ko kaushal bhavishya ki kamna karte hain. Dhanyawad.
We're moving fast. These are already the speeches. And our first speaker, our first distinguished speaker, is Adolf Ogi, who has been president of Switzerland and who is the founder of the foundation Freude herrscht, which means let's enjoy. And let me welcome him on stage for his speech.
Dear students, Mr. President, Academic Dean, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, what a day, what a pleasure to be here to celebrate with the young generation, with you. Ladies and gentlemen, we desperately need a better world. We desperately need the young generation. We desperately need a better life, a more peaceful world, a world where people are secure, a world where our children are not afraid to go to school, a world with freedom and justice for all. We need a new road to success. We need to shape the future. Ladies and gentlemen, the world is out of balance. We still have conflicts, wars, violence, terrorism, diseases. We have natural disasters. We have hunger and poverty. We have corona. We have economical problems. We have immigration problems. But we have you. You, the young generation. You, the successful generation. You, the young generation, are the leaders of tomorrow. In politics, in the economy, in the science, in culture, in the military, in sport, in the media, everywhere. So it is important to give you the chance to create a better world. And I am sure you will do it. And I am sure you will succeed. Chers étudiants, mesdames et messieurs, nous avons accompli des progrès formidables au cours du XXe siècle, mais nous avons échoué dans le développement humain. Le XXIe siècle devra être celui des solutions, des progrès humains, le respect vis-à-vis des minorités. Il faut que l'éthique et la confiance reviennent au centre de notre activité. Donc nous avons besoin de politiciens, d'économistes, de commerçants, de scientifiques, de religieux, de journalistes, de banquiers, de sportifs qui aiment les gens, qui respectent les gens. Mesdames et messieurs, c'est si simple. Donc nous avons besoin de vous, parce que votre formation ici, à European Business School, vous connaissez maintenant les gens, vous comprenez les gens, vous aimez les gens, et vous parvenez maintenant à soutenir les gens. L'avenir est en vos mains. I had several principles in all my duties. First, I do what I believe in, and I believe in what I do. Second, serve. We should be all servant to a good cause. Third, do it. Don't just talk about it. Do it. Fourth, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. And fifth, there are windows of opportunity. They open and they close. You have to use them when they are open, when there is a chance, when there is a new opportunity. I know the business school does not score goals, does not break records, but the school brings people together, you, build bridges between communities, between you. The school is a door opener for understanding and for peace. The EU school, with its lessons of integration, of tolerance, of disciplines, lessons of fair play, respect, can help to solve problems. And it is a toolkit for your life. My goal in all my activities was to build up a new generation, like the EU school does. A generation, ladies and gentlemen, which has learned the lessons and the values for a better life, for a better world. A generation which will deal with all the problems of the world always in the interest of the people. So if we believe in what we do, and we do what we believe in, then we can together create a better world. Dear students, you can achieve great things. You can establish companies. You can lead business. You can be successful. All walks, no matter which path you choose. Congratulations, you are great. The future is in your hands. All the best, congratulations, well done.
Thank you, Mr. Ogi. This morning in a seminar, we put like 300 problems of the world on the table to discover that we have most of the solutions. We know most of the solutions. And the word that Mr. Ogi used most is do. And I think that is what this world needs. Which brings me then to the next speaker. When I first met with our student Noël de Mol many years ago, not many, no, so it's eight or something like this, five plus, she had a mission in her dreams that she discovered step by step and that she's realizing step by step. And Noël de Mol graduated from us with less than 5 years ago, went to Colombia, went to many nice places, and did it. You may have heard about Shere Khan, but not in the same circumstances, because we all watched that movie. But she has a foundation called the Shere Khan Youth Protection, and she's going to explain everything about that and the steps to take. The floor is yours.
Dear students, dear professors, it is an honor for me to be invited here to deliver the graduation speech for your ceremony. A special thanks to my friend Suda, who kindly gave me this opportunity. First of all, congratulations to everyone on your graduation. What a great day. However, I did not come here today to simply congratulate you and tell you that the doors of the future are going to open by themselves now. It's tougher than you think out there. I am here to tell you about the importance of failures and accepting them as they will come along. Knowing how to get back up on track no matter what is something I did not understand when I graduated 5 years ago in this same room with my bachelor's degree. I guarantee you that you will succeed a lot in life, but I guarantee you also that you will fail. You will be facing difficult and disappointing experiences at some point. It's just how life works, and it's okay. It's a part of the deal. I'm telling you from experience. Sometimes you might even think that life is putting one challenge after the other on purpose, and you will get this feeling that it's just easy to give up and stop. But what is most important to keep along the way is will. Average skill, phenomenal will. Average skill, phenomenal will. This is a quote from a great guy called Eric Thomas. He's an American motivational speaker that I listen to very often and whom I got the opportunity to meet in person when I was living in New York 2 years ago. He used to say this, "It's not about the skill, it's about the will." And his words stayed with me ever since. I consider myself average, to be honest. I was never the best in school. I was never the best in high school. I was definitely not the best during my bachelor's degree at EU, thanks to that accounting class that was just horrible for me. I was not the best either during my master's degree at all. And I already know in advance that I'm not going to be the best during my PhD studies starting as of September. But I know this. I learned how to develop extraordinary will, the will to never give up. If you never give up on things that you really want, they actually end up by happening to you one way or another, no matter how much it will take. I guarantee you this. It's not about the skill. It's not about how smart you can be. It's not about the connections you have either. And it's not about where you come from. And it's neither about the grades nor the degrees you get. It's honestly about mental strength that you have to find and say to yourself, I am not leaving this dream until I get it done. Even when things get hard, continue to move forward. Heads down, step by step, every day. A lot of people will tell you no. No to university applications, a lot. No to job applications. No to new business ideas. No to new projects. People might even make fun of you. They might leave you. But let that no excite you. Never take no as a final answer. At first, I used to be very ashamed of failing. I even lied so that no one would know that I failed. And then I decided to change. I let no become my everyday fuel, my gasoline. The more people will tell you no, the more you must prove them wrong. The more people would not believe in me, the more I build up that energy to fight back. Never forget that success is the best revenge. By graduating today, you are proving something of high importance. This is probably the best advice that I want to give you today, to never give up. In addition to this, after I graduated, I struggled a lot with comparing myself to others in terms of timing. How wrong I was. You have to create your success at your own rhythm, at your own pace. There's time. There's no rush needed to achieve your academic and professional goals. Some of you may already know what you're going to do with your lives, but some of you may not, and you might even not know for the next coming years. But it doesn't matter, who cares? So what if it took you a bit longer to figure yourself out? There's no competition. And once you find your interests, work hard to build on that career. And do not look back. Even if it scares you, this means it's the right thing to do. I struggled. I was lost, and I had no idea what I was going to do when I was 18, 20 years old. And after that struggle, in these past 6 years, I was trying to figure out what was my destiny and my goals. And I have found a job that I love every day in a private bank working as an anti-money laundering and anti-terrorism financing specialist. And it took me a year and a half, almost 2 years, to find a job because of COVID, but also because of the competition and the amount of people applying for the same jobs. I also found the time to set up my own NGO, helping young homeless individuals getting out of the streets in the south of India. It took me 3 years to achieve that and to get results. And I will soon be a PhD student in criminology, researching on the issues of human trafficking and modern-day slavery. It took me almost 2 years to get an offer, but I got it. At 28 years old, I have found my way. Only at 28 years old. There's time. And EU helped me a lot in my successes. EU Business School is not just a school like the others, at least to me. It is much more. It is a unique academic institution that provides you with authentic guidance for your future goals and dreams. And those professors that are here today, all of them, they will be there for you in the coming years, even after you graduate. They will be there. Build relationships with them. Take their advices seriously. Ask them for support. They know more than us. They know better than us because they have the experience of life that we don't. They have been there for me for the past 5 to 6 years, and they're continuing to be there, and I know that I can count on them in the future. They won't drop you just because you're done. So again, I owe a lot of my successes today to this school and these professors, because it started right here for me. And it also starts for you today, right here, right now. Today you leave this graduation taking with you new friends for life, of course, intellectual independence, team playing values, but most of all, courage. Today you've achieved something that is not just that not just anybody can achieve easily. This degree you earned is a ticket to that next great adventure of your life, but also your strongest weapon to get to that next level. Never stop getting to that next level, even if you fail and you experience difficulties along the way. It's normal. So go to that next step and make the rest of your life the best of your life. I wish you all the best in your next future endeavors and projects. Thank you very much, and congratulations again, class of 2021.
That was impressive, and I can give you the statistics because I ticked it during my life. It takes roughly 149 no's before you get a yes. So keep on going and keep that mission. And that mission is actually going to formulate bit by bit as you go along, and that is the long path. Our next speaker is Dirk Crane, who has been with us long, over 20 years, it says here. I think it's much more. He is the president of the school. He's inspired us with his vision. He's taken the EU to new heights of success, and I would say almost every year. President Crane has challenged our students to think outside the box. I think to think even without a box, to seize every leadership opportunity, and to connect with the EU community. He's mentored our community of faculty, staff, and alumni, and he's leading the business school strategically into the future. We are championing excellence in business education and in entrepreneurial leadership. Join me in welcoming Dr. Crane.
Dear President Oggi, dear graduates, faculty members, and guests, dear alumni, first of all, congratulations to the class of 2021. You made it. From today on, you sit in the driver's seat of your career. Follow the optimist quote: think and act always in the yes form. The three letters of yes stay for young, entrepreneurial, and successful. Think about what motivates you and what your definition of success and happiness is. What is your most valuable asset? It's your reputation. The ability to start, complete, and finish tasks successfully. To be known that you are reliable, that you get things done. Be a doer and an achiever. Challenge your beliefs. Dream, believe in them, and move forward to your goals. Be different from your competitors and colleagues. Strive to be the best. A world of infinite opportunities is waiting for you after the pandemic period. Your generation think differently, more target-oriented than people of my generation. You explore business opportunities and life through your new digital networks. You live and sleep with your mobile phone, your iPad, your laptop, your computers. You adapt the forms of artificial intelligence in your daily life. Have a woe attitude, W-O-W. The first W is to be a winner. The second O is the O to discover opportunities. And if you see opportunities, ask and think always why. You will be successful if you are action-oriented. I know a lot of university people. They all know how to do it, but they never do it. So you don't have a degree. You are, from today, a bachelor, an MBA, a doctorate. But put that knowledge also in a practical scenario. You must today to be a game changer. There is a new period after the COVID who comes to us, the period of disruption. You have to see, think differently. That's your daily duty. Your success will be influenced by your ideas, fast acting, creativity, vision, and certainly by your imagination. Be bold, brave, and brilliant. And don't stop learning. Continue to be curious every day. There are opportunities every day coming to you. And the most important thing is to conclude these opportunities, be result-driven. By 2050, we have to reach a sustainable world at 100%, with a zero carbon emission, and will be fully digitalized. That's a big goal to obtain. Huh? The climate issue is one of our biggest concerns and challenges. Therefore, there are enough opportunities coming to you to create new ideas, new scenarios, and you can be successful in this new world. Therefore, you need to be a networker. You need to work in team. You need to find other leaders, and finding other people, there you have to be a giver. When you talk with people in business, you don't have only to ask to take, but you have first to give from your personality, from your ideas. And when you can convince people and you are not a authentic thinker, at that moment, you will have a lot of opportunities who will come to you. Be a global citizen, no difference of color, un citoyen du monde. Therefore, when you have your degree, observe, study, open your mind, and open certainly your heart to all what the world can give to you. At the EU, you forge already relations, relationships. Keep them. Important in life is what you know, but even more important in life will bring you further in your career is who you know, your network. Therefore, don't stay in your city, but go international. Be a world manager. You create added value through your network. Be yourself. When you make progress in your career, don't start to go to the heaven. You can be ambitious, but you will be driven by a lot of opportunities in the future. So when you think, change your vision. When you explore, change your market. When you disrupt, change your strategy. When you inspire, change your brand. When you resonate, change your story. When you impact, change your result. Reinvent yourself. You read that every day. Take the essence of what you are and let go of everything else. And it's in your own strengths that you can think and to reinvent the product, the ideas you have. Reinvent the world, drive radical innovation for our hot, overcrowded, and resource-depleted planet. There is a need for real, radical, disruptive, innovative approach to cope with resource scarcity. Mahatma Gandhi said once, "We must be the change we wish to see in the world." Observing something is, everyone can do that, but do it, be a doer. Therefore, make your decision faster, earlier, and with greater conviction than your competitors and colleagues. Today, you earn a bachelor, a master, a doctorate. Be yourself. You don't have a degree. You are a degree. That paper must be an entrance ticket for your career. You have enormous challenges waiting for you in a world who needs you. Be performant from the first day. Focus on delivering results. See things differently. But most of all, be an open thinker. If you see water, don't follow the stream to the sea. A lot of people, they follow it because they think there is much more water at the ocean. There are more opportunities. The real opportunities are in the mountains, at the spring, where the water comes from. And that was also the reason why, but this is a joke, I came from Belgium to Switzerland. In one sentence, be a doer, driven by the future and not by the past. The future belongs to you. I had once a client and he said, "Yes, Dirk, but you are richer than me." I said, "Mr. Nomekens, you are such a big entrepreneur." I said, "With all my money, I cannot buy your age. And you have a future before you. And let me motivate that with you. You have knowledge now, but it depends on your character, on your willingness, on your drive, on your sense to be curious, to make a career." So, my last words go to my faculty. Thank you for believing from the first moment in my message when I heard Mr. de Jong, Professor de Jong. and some other faculty members. And thank you, students, for believing in EU Business School, the ones who applied. And thank you for your confidence, your trust and generosity. You made me richer in my mind, not in money, in my mind. And that's, I have to say, Dr. Ogi has the same view on that. He listened to the young people because you are the power of our society. You will have to make it. So we believe in you, and thank you for choosing EU, for your confidence, your trust, and your generosity. Thank you for the moments of fun. You gave us a lot of fun and excellence you brought to us. Have a successful journey. Keep in touch with us. And I will say it in French because we are in Geneva. Au revoir, au prochain rendez-vous. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Crane, for these inspiring words. So we can now move to the award, and then you'll get your diplomas, don't worry, huh? This is going to happen. The award of the this year is the award that goes to one person that you know, because you may have seen the Learning from Leaders, and who presents those, Peter van Ham. And he will be presented with the award by President Crane and Mr. Ogi for the work he did in this and altogether. Would Mr. Peter van Ham, head of International Media Council and chairman's communication at the World Economic Forum, author of several business books, including Before I Was a CEO, and co-host of our Learning from Leaders series, please come to the stage. The King Fellow Award is presented to Mr. Peter van Ham in recognition of his illustrious career and his dedication and commitment to inspiring students by bringing them into contact with top global thought leaders. Thank you, Mr. van Ham. Mm-hmm. Now we can present the degrees. We will now begin conferring the degrees upon the graduating students of the classes of 2020 and 2021. The act of conferring the degree symbolizes the admission of each graduate into the company of scholars and the dedication of each recipient to use their knowledge to help build a better and more humane world. The presentation of the candidates for graduation signifies the students' anticipated successful completion of the school's requirements for a degree. Each candidate for graduation will come forward individually. In your commencement program, you can find a listing of our bachelor's, master's, and MBA graduates. These degrees will be presented at the same time as the student is recognized. Each student will receive the degree from President Crane, assisted by Mr. Ogi. I'll call the candidates by program, first the bachelor's, then the master's, followed by the MBA, and finally DBA. And in each group, we'll call the graduate students by specialization and alphabet. As you see, this is all organized. I will now read the names of the graduates, Bachelor of Business Administration. Niven Manfred de Witt from South Africa with a GPA of 3.7 on a 4 scale with honors and magna cum laude. Manrico Yacha from Portugal, with a GPA of 3.7 on a 4.0 scale, also with honors magna cum laude. Gala Garcia from Peru, with a GPA of 3.2 on a 4.0 scale, with honors cum laude. Name of the graduating students for the Bachelor of Arts in Business and Design Management degree. Laura Mirpuri from Portugal, with a GPA of 3.9 on a 4.0 scale, with honors summa cum laude. 3.9 is not bad at all, huh? Kristina Bulesheva from Russia, with a GPA of 2.9 at a 4.0 scale. Congratulations. I will now read the names of the eminent graduates for the Bachelor of Business Administration. Iman Karic from Bosnia and Herzegovina. I will now read the names of the eminent graduates for the Bachelor of Arts in Communication and Public Relations. Jeremy Tete-Nete from Switzerland. Bachelor of Arts in International Relations, Olivia Buitenwerf. From the Netherlands. What is wrong here? And I forgot Kusha Kazaroni. I'm sorry, but I always sometimes make errors. But the best ones. Bachelor of Arts in International Relations, Olivia, we just mentioned, Alua Taimerdinova from Kazakhstan. Bachelor of Science in Business Finance, Titiksha Anil Jain from India. Nuria Casanova from Kazakhstan. And Thomas Nabusi from Cameroon. With that, we have finished the bachelor's and we can move on to the master's. I will now read the name of the graduating student for the Master of Management, Gezim Mikuli from Kosovo, with a GPA of 3.1 on a 4.0 scale. Graduating student for the Master in Innovation and Entrepreneurship, Roman Kristal from Russia. And with a GPA of 3.9 on a 4.0 scale, summa cum laude. That merits a second applause. I will now read the name of the eminent graduate for the Master in Management, Niven Manfred de Witt from South Africa. Nihari Rediguda from India. And we can move to the MBAs. We can welcome the MBA students to the stage. Master of Business Administration, which a major in Global Banking and Finance, Michele Alessandro Montalvo di Giacomo from Spain. GPA of 3.4. a Master of Business Administration with a major in digital business and a major in entrepreneurship, Vania Zora Adistia from Indonesia. A GPA of 3.7 on a 4.0 scale, magna cum laude. For the Master of Business Administration with a major in international business, Anastasia Shimakela from Namibia. Master of Business Administration with a major in Communication and Public Relations, Mahigadzi Ali Higadzi from Egypt. I will now read the name of the eminent graduates for the Master of Business Administration with a major in Global Banking and Finance, Ralph Richard Bendo from Switzerland. And Olawale Abdullahi Oparinola from Nigeria. The major in entrepreneurship goes to Aria Minisale from Italy. Then we proceed to the presentation of the doctorate degree. We will now welcome the doctorate student to the stage. I will read the name of the doctorate student for the Doctor of Business Administration, Angelina Müller from Ukraine, with a GPA of 3.8 on a scale of 4. This is summa cum laude. And we also have a few special awards to students and faculty. At EU Business School, students distinguish themselves in a variety of ways, both in and out of the classroom. We would now like to honor those students whose academic performance has been truly exceptional. As I read the names of the recipients, each student will receive their award and be congratulated by Dr. Luc Crane, assisted by Vice President and Managing Director Luc Crane and Dr. Oggy. So now we agree it's Oggy and Luc who will do this. The first award goes to the bachelor students who has received the highest GPA of their class, 3.8 on 4, summa cum laude, and this is Laura Mirpuri. And you should stay there, Laura, because now we move to the students with the best bachelor dissertation, and we have two awardees, Laura Mepuri. And Gala Garcia. Congratulations to Gala and Laura. Then we can move to the Master Student Awards. The highest GPA and the best master for that final project goes to Roman Christoph. And he merits the applause because his project had been related to one of our major school projects and has been the subject to a lot of discussions, but I must say this is well done and a 3.9 is excellent. So then we can move to the students in the MBA, highest GPA and best MBA dissertation, Vania Zora Adistia. Mm-hmm. 3.7 mm-hmm. with honors magna cum laude. Mm-hmm. 3.7 Miss Adistia. Mm-hmm. And then we can move to the DBA Student Award. Mm-hmm. This year, the award for the highest GPA and the best DBA dissertation, designated as summa cum laude, goes to Angelina Muller. And she has been delivering excellent work, and she's by far not the only one who submitted this year, so maybe she's the only one on this reception, but she did excellent work. GPA 3.8. Hmm? Congratulations to Angelina. Hmm? Congratulations to everyone, because you all did a great job and you all made it. And now we can move to the next series. As well as our students' academic accomplishment, we must also recognize their success in upholding social activities. And our social responsibility policies, both inside and outside the classroom, were specially promoted by the EU Business School Student Board, who played a dynamic role in student life and activities. And to show our recognition, we would like the student representative to come on stage to be presented with the Prince Fellow Award. I would like to see Olivia Buitenwerf. Gala Garcia and Kusha Cazzaroni. That's the student board. They can put that on their CV, and these things work. Huh? We also recognize students who played an active role in promoting a more dynamic and social environment at EU Business School. And there's a Prince Fellow Award to Iman Karic. Faculty. Every year, EU chooses faculty members who exemplify the best of their profession based on their continuous support and hard work. The 2021 EU Prince Fellow Award goes to the following faculty member. 3 seconds. Professor Joanne Jankowski. Joanne set up the quality control system at the school. She's the head of academic quality. And if it says your continuous support, that means a 24/7, and hard work means a lot of work. So she truly merits this. Plus, we took into account the students' opinions. It's now time for students to address the audience. It's a tradition at EU Business School to recognize the students who have demonstrated loyalty and enthusiasm towards EU Business School. And I would like to introduce our speaker, Gala Garcia, who will speak to you on her. The rostrum is yours.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thanks for being here. So, before starting, I just want to say that you don't have to cry during my speech, okay? However, I would feel better if you do. So, if you want to, it's up to you. Okay. So taking this last bit into consideration, I'd like to thank my family, because without you, standing here wouldn't be possible. I'd also like to thank EU Business School, because it is the common denominator in our lives. The reason we met, the one who nurtured our love for business and strived to be more, for thinking outside of the box, the one who gave us all the tools to succeed, the one who made us reach our highest levels of creativity. To the faculty members, thank you for sharing your knowledge with us throughout the whole program. We have learned a great deal from you, and we will never forget you. You are the ones we look up to. Also, to the staff members of EU Business School, thank you so much, because you made it all possible. You kept looking after us, and I'm pretty sure we weren't easy to handle. So thank you so much for all the assistance we had in the past years. I want to thank our families. Without you and your constant support, this day would have never come. Thank you for your love, for giving us the strength when we needed it the most, and for believing in us. And finally, thank you, class 2020 and 2021, because we have finally made it. I know we said it a lot of times, so thank you. I want to dedicate this speech to you, the ones who are here and the ones who could not make it. Gosh, we're a legacy, okay? We made history in EU Business School. I mean, whoever graduated from EU in the middle of a pandemic, it wasn't an easy task to do, so congratulations to all of you and us in general. I'm gonna be completely honest with you, because when I got asked to do this commencement speech, I said yes without realizing the nervousness of doing it. But after freaking out a little bit, I realized that it is much bigger than just speaking in public. I was speaking for every single person in the room, so I freaked out a little more. But you know what helped me? Watching videos of the past 3 years. Looking at those moments really helped me and made me realize that I created a family, and that I was going to be doing this speech for all of you, my second home, and I feel completely honored to do it. So I hope you enjoy listening to it as much as I enjoyed writing it. I'd like for all of you to take a trip down memory lane and remember back when you were in transition of leaving your home country, your friends, your family, moving to a whole different country and adapting to a new culture. The fright and nervousness of meeting new people, wondering how the next years of your lives were going to be. I want you to remember the first time you visited the university, your first orientation day, your first welcome drinks. Okay, you're not gonna remember this one, but let's pretend you do. Your first class, your first friend, your first friend, if you know what I mean, your first group project. Yes, that's the equivalent of Uno cards in university. Your first withdrawal, reset, retake. It's too late to hide it, you guys, so let's just face it. We've been there. Never thought these years were going to be as amazing as they were. With that in mind, I want you to reflect on how much we've grown. This past 3 years might not seem too long when you're just saying it, or in the case of MBAs, just 1 year. We may have come with a dream, but this changed in between these years. Something to plan for the future. But now we can make it. Now it's not only a dream. It's not some idea floating in the air, waiting for the moment to be put on the field. Because from now on, we are on the field. Now we have the chance to put those ideas, those dreams, into the world, because we're strong. We can achieve anything we want to, and I'm pretty sure we will. It wasn't only thanks to Google, Wikipedia, or Investopedia, but it was also thanks to our effort, our dedication, and our strength. Thanks to these, we are now able to make it on our own, closing one of the best stages in our lives. Now, I am supposed to write to cite a philosopher, an author, or an intellectual. At least that's what all the videos of best commencement speeches of all time do. But I have planned to cite a phrase that I believe we can all relate to. This is actually me realizing that going to universities and partying every day and being part of a sorority. The credit goes to a meme found on Instagram. I know some of you may have thought about this, okay? And some of you may have not. However, I'm pretty sure that we can all agree that these years have been no joke. This is all part of a journey we had to take in order to achieve our goals. Those dreams we wanted to come true when we started. And it brings me joy to see that we are now leaving to reach those goals, to prove ourselves. I see communicators, some of you fighting for justice, some of you creating your own empire. But do you know what I see in all of you? I see success. It brings me joy to see that now we can all have the opportunity to do whatever the hell we want. And it makes me sad that we will have to follow our separate paths to do it. Who would have thought that it will be this hard to say goodbye, and so soon? It is ironic how some of us waited for the hours to go fast so we could go on a break. I'm sorry. Okay. But have recently found ourselves in the position where we would like time to go a little slower to enjoy the time that we have with each other. Okay. Thanks. Okay, so enough about all of that. I knew I was going to cry, so I put something fun for the next thing. And let's be honest, we're going to miss the teachers, okay? We're going to miss you, aren't we? Come on. How can we forget about De Jong's inverse writing? Come on, like, I cannot even write my name in reverse. That's the word I know the most. And how much are we going to miss Professor Lama's homeworks? They were the best. No, we're not going to miss those, I'm sorry. But we're going to miss you. We're going to miss you. And how about Professor Berger's amazing accent? He's not here today, I'm sorry. But probably you will show this to you. But y'all jealous you can say Manet the way he does, huh? Okay? And the reason why I cited a phrase, a meme, instead of a philosopher of any or anything, is not because I'm only trying to be funny, okay? I want everybody to know. Our future generations, the people who will be sitting in those chairs in 3 years, that reaching this point is a conglomerate of ups and downs, of deciding to give up and having the strength to continue, of late nights, of patience, of effort. And it is okay to feel that way, because we are no robots. We have ups and downs. But the main thing that you need to focus on is that the sun will always rise after the storm. And to you, class of 2020 and 2021, when you find difficult to stay focused and to when you find it that it's hard to move on, just remember that you already felt it and that you succeeded. So you can succeed with anything you put your mind into. We graduated during a pandemic. Give yourself some credit for that and always remember it. Being here shows that we have been consistent throughout the last years. We know how it is, we've been there. And I'm not saying that what's coming will be easier. In fact, I'm pretty sure it will be hard. Like, we know it's going to be hard. But every memorable new experience is, isn't it? And the satisfaction we will get then will be even greater. We're not scared, we're valuable. We can eat the world now if we want to. We're capable of anything. We're invincible. So I want to invite all of you to continue having dreams. Maybe those dreams we had 3 years ago aren't the same. Maybe they've changed. Maybe you don't even remember them by now. Maybe you have new dreams. It's part of our growth process. So dream, because if we want to make history,
We have to dream about it first. And remember what I said about quotes and like that I don't want. Did I say that? I don't like quotes, but okay. Walter Disney said, actually, first think, second dream, third believe, and fourth dare. So I hope that the next time we see each other again, we can say that we dared. So enjoy the ride, because I want to see you rise until the sun. Thank you very much.
Dear graduates, you all go to have a beautiful future. I received this week an email from a former student of EU Montreux, Tobias. I don't say his name, but he became this week CFO of Mercedes-Benz, the Americas. So you have all the potential to make a beautiful career. He was a brilliant student, but not the best of his class. So I hope that in the future, you'll make the same career, that you fulfill your dreams. And to close, we have to name you the address of the recessional. Graduates, today we celebrate your accomplishment in earning your degree. The faculty, staff, and administration are proud to have been part of this process, to see you now and to celebrate with you. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of EU Business School, I now confer upon each of you who have successfully completed all requirements the appropriate degree, with all honors, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Please move the tassel on your cap to the left. I now ask the faculty and the audience here, and also at home in your living room, because you follow us by television or by computer, to stand up and give a big round applause to the graduate classes of 2020 and 2021. You made it!
Before we'll drink a glass to that, there is a bomb in the green bag behind you. Take that bomb out. You're all terrorists. And then you'll make it explode. But I would like that to happen at the same moment. So I'm not very good at that because I'm a beginner. But I suppose if you open the orange side, wow, that's how you do it. Let me count. 3, 2, 1, 0. Thank you very much. You've made it. This is the beginning of action. Now take an action. Let's have a glass of champagne in front.
We have found our way. It's a brand new day. And we'll be making history. Are you with me? Won't you stay? have come so far. This is who we are. And like the rising sun, we have just begun to play our part. This is the time we form the chorus. Lift your